Let's speak now to a political activist and founder of the Institute of Islamic Political Thought, Azam Tamimi, joins us live from here in Istanbul. Welcome to the programme. What do you make of President Biden's Summit for Democracy, its timing, and just in general, American democracy as a model for other countries to follow right now?
Well, I'm reminded by an editorial that was published in The Economist several years ago that had the headline, "What does democracy mean to America?" Mm-hmm. And the answer was, it means two things, free market and posing no threat to America. And it is really truly regrettable that democracy, which is a noble idea and a set of procedures that is meant to prevent despotism and curtail corruption, is used by a superpower like the United States of America to enhance its power and authority around the world. That's all they really care about.
And give us example, because the United States is a political reputation, or its reputation is not popular all around the world, also, of course, in the Middle East. Tell us a bit more about that.
Well, just take two examples from the Middle East. Egypt, where a military coup toppled the first ever elected president in the history of Egypt, and the United States of America, as if it saw nothing and it heard nothing. Next door, Israel commits all sorts of crimes against humanity, yet it is protected and considered to be a model for democracy in the region. Such double standards is not just unique to the Middle East. It's all over the world, in Latin America, in Africa, in Asia, where the United States of America considers only its allies to be worthy of protection and even of living.
So given what you're saying, would you say, is it fair to say that the US doesn't have the moral authority, well, President Biden and the US don't have the moral authority to be hosting such a summit right now?
Not at all. Democracy within the country itself, of course, it has rules and institutions. And someone living in the United States of America would probably feel more comfortable, safer than living in some of the third countries where dictatorships rule. Yet, when it comes to foreign policy, democracy is used as a tool in order to bring to their knees other nations. The United States of America simply tell them, you are either with us or you are against us. And we've seen this all over the past decades, administration after administration doing the same thing.
And can democracy be protected at all?
Of course it can. Democracy needs to be protected by a set of ethics, of morality. Now, regrettably, Western liberal democracies developed their democratic systems when they were the most brutal colonial powers in the world. Therefore, democracy and human rights for them are exclusive and not inclusive. They apply aspects of them within their own countries, but when it comes to people outside, they are not worthy of democracy, they are not worthy of human rights.
Always a pleasure to speak to you, Azam Tamimi, political activist. Appreciate your time.